Hello, welcome back to Let's Play Ground Control as we continue the single-player campaign. Last time we finished... Oh, it looks like we finished off the the Craven campaign. And it looks like there's an Order campaign now. Well, that's a bit of a surprise to me since the whole manual was written from the point of view of a Craven field manual. I figured the information on the Order was just for... informational purposes, you know, like what's-his-face was going to be our opposite number, but we never actually faced him in battle. Or even had intelligence that he was anywhere near the front, so I guess he's going to be our player character now for the rest of the game. Unless there's like a third campaign. Some games like to do that, show you a campaign from both sides and then have a third campaign for that true ending, but I guess we'll... I guess I'm going to have to reorganize my videos now, just to make the labeling consistent with what I do for other games. But yeah, let's see what the Order's about and what their starting point is.
We have failed. Failed the Order, failed God, who is the promise of a new dawn. Failed ourselves. The heretics from the Craven Corporation have seized Krieg 7B and stolen the voice of God. The priests of the Pax Dei have told us time and again of the ancient relics and their importance. And yet, in our arrogance, we have allowed the enemy to use them against us. Now our sacred starship has been driven from orbit, and we are alone on this barren world, surrounded by our enemies. Most of our heavy vehicles have been destroyed, communications are in shambles, and Craven is everywhere. The radio is filled with her wicked, beguiling voice, urging our surrender. I cannot shake the feeling of dread which has haunted me since I stepped foot on this world. First, Bishop Delandre went mad and tried to join the enemy. I've never had to kill a believer, a friend, before. Then we were defeated just as our scholars were preparing to awaken the relics and bring forth the Word of God. If it were not for the presence of those holy relics, I would consider this world cursed. But I will not yield. I am a deacon of the Pax Dei and a loyal servant to my order. I will rally my men. Our enemies will not sleep well after this dark victory. I know that the Paladin Magnus still roams this world, a free agent of God. If I can only contact him, I am certain he will know what we can do. As the sun rises, so shall our power grow. So it has been, so it will be again.
I am glad you still live, my friend. Praise the light.
Praise the light. Yes, I live. Half my command has also managed to survive the treacherous Craven assault. I feel the need to strike back at the unbelievers. But without the support of our starship and the words of a priest, how can we act?
The best we can. I have been making my way through the desert and have made contact with a few stranded dropships. We will have to use them as makeshift transports until our starship returns in force. Until then, I think I have discovered a way to recover some of the equipment captured by the Craven. They have a base here. They're getting ready to convoy out a large load of captured weapons. You must get into the base, retrieve what your troops can carry, and destroy the rest.
But how? I remember that base. It is too well defended to be taken by the forces I have now.
Things are too dangerous for normal conventions, my friend. To survive and bring misery to the heathen, you are going to have to improvise. You cannot defeat the defenders in honorable combat, but you can lure them out with a diversionary force while your remaining marines sneak into the base.
I do not like skulking around the enemy like a dog, but I see your point. Sun, forgive us. So, where is the best place for a diversion?
The Krays have four outlying guard posts surrounding the main base. One to the northeast, southeast, southwest, and to the northwest. Just remember to have your incursion force hold their fire until they find the truck convoy. The outer guard units will fall back as soon as they realize the main base has been penetrated.
I understand. I will go prepare my men. Light be with you, brother.
And you, my friend. Magnus out.
Alright, so that cutscene actually makes it seem like we were fighting him the whole time, or at least part of the time. It was his forces we faced on the second mission when we had to recover the Bishop Delandre, and he was obviously present at the fall of the Order Command Base. I like how they found some stranded dropships because they didn't want to have to rework the game to have your units start pre-set up. It looks like all we get is a squadron of Crusader infantry and a squadron of light hoverdines. So we have the Dark Prophets and the Soul Reapers. We'll go offensive on the infantry because we should have a command APC to ferry them around. As far as the Soul Reapers go, you know what? Let's go offensive on them too. Yeah, so I guess that's all the setup we can really do. We can't fit anyone with any special equipment, so let's get started.
New drop zone.
Ooh, new voice and everything. Interface is all red.
Landing vehicle entering atmosphere.
And the very interesting...
Mission update. You must pull the Kraven security forces out of position by attacking one of these outposts.
Alright, so... our armor is going to be a lot lighter now, but we should have more... versatility in being able to climb terrain. So the outpost is in this valley, so we'll probably want to set up.
Yes, Deacon. We will move. We shall move at once, Deacon.
We'll just attack. That's pretty well defended.
Move order received.
But at least by the terrain. Obviously, I don't know what forces they have there.
Move command.
I'm just trying to think what routes their this convoy is gonna take.
Yes, Deacon.
Can we get there? Move. Kind of, maybe. Alright, if we follow this, we can get up here.
We shall move at once, Deacon.
That should get us there. Up, we have spotted the enemy. They have an ammo depot. Deacon. And hopefully that's all. Now, since this is the first mission of the campaign and our forces are very limited, I'm hoping we won't run into too much opposition here, but I guess we'll find out.
Yes, Deacon, we are moving.
I think
Squad
I was...
two taking hostile fire.
Oh, there we go. They have Marine infantry.
Mission update. Kraven security is reacting as planned. Recommendation. Circle around and enter the main base from the opposite direction.
Hostile infantry eliminated.
Well, we can certainly do
Squad
that.
Squad 2 taking command hostile fire. Understood.
And we'll keep them occupied.
Affirmative. Attacking.
For now, and then we'll destroy that ammo depot and then circle around back. We rejoin our APC here.
Yes, Deacon. We will move.
Okay, so we should be able to come in through here to the main base. All right.
Enemy structure destroyed.
Yes, Deacon, we move order received.
Let's,
Waypoint added.
Catch up with our APC
Waypoint
now.
Waypoint added.
What else are they seeing here? Oh, there's a container. Whoop-de-doo. Attacking you, draw attention away from you. Alright, so everyone should be rushing... if they're right, everyone should be rushing to that outpost. I like how I have them set for line, but they're really moving in column formation. So basically, I want them to join up with the APC, get some little repairs. I don't think those two Marines did much to us, but just want to top them off, and then we can hit that convoy with all of our forces, hopefully. I wish these guys would move a bit faster, but I mean, I shouldn't complain too much. They probably move faster than the light pterodynes that we're accustomed to. Maybe I should have gone bounce for this operation instead of firepower, but... Alright, let's just have them pursue the shortest path now. Now we're in kind of a staggered column line formation. There we go. I was going to say, I thought you could follow objects. God, this gives me kind of flashbacks to Star Trek New Worlds, actually. Alright, so... Let's get whatever repairs we can.
Squad 2 regenerated.
Again, there should... Okay, so our fourth light hover dying here took a little bit of damage, but...
Yes, Deacon, it, we are moving.
The rest we can fix on the move.
Yes,
so let's get down there.
Yes, Deacon, we
or rather,
are
let's go straight through there. Okay.
Yes, Deacon. Yes, Deacon, we are moving.
Oh, they can't. All right. Close enough. I guess we'll lead with our APC and hope that doesn't bite us in the butt. But we can deploy the Crusaders pretty quickly, so I'm not too worried. And yet, oh wow, we are moving a lot faster than Sarah's APC ever moved. The light pterodynes outpaced our APC,
alert.
I think.
You must find and destroy the trucks quickly. Succeed or be destroyed yourself.
Alright, they have a ton of containers there.
We shall move at once.
Let's find the trucks, though, since those are our priority.
Move command understood. Yes, Deacon. We will move.
Where are these supposed trucks?
We shall move at once, Deacon. Move command understood. Yes, Deacon. We will move.
Attack order received.
We shall move at once, Deacon.
Wait, there's...
Move command understood.
They're not... I don't think they're there, though. We can at least destroy...
Yes, Deacon.
Yeah, we'll drop,
Enemy structure destroyed.
We can do that. Let's check in there.
Affirmative. Attacking.
I like how both sides are trying to terraform, but it ends up being a valid target, even though we're both trying to get the same goal.
You have found the target vehicles. Recommendation: destroy the remaining equipment and retreat to the drop zone.
All right.
Yes, Deacon, we are moving.
So they're, structure destroyed.
Oh, they're using a bunch of captured 10-ton transporters.
Move order received.
So we're going to move the light hoverdynes in there. Let the Crusaders keep working their magic over here. I'm kind of curious how many defenders they actually have.
Line of fire. Squad 2 regenerating.
There we
Squad
go.
Squad 2 taking friendly fire. Hostile hoverdyne eliminated.
Affirmative. Attacking.
Power station Mark II.
Affirmative.
Focus Engage on that. We'll leave our God, our command hoverdyne feels so much more useful than Sarah's APC ever did. Come on.
Enemy structure destroyed.
Order received. We are on our way.
Advance and fire.
Order received.
Destroy all these Kraven containers.
You have completed your objective. A dropship has been summoned and will arrive at the designated pickup point.
Alright, well, we should be able to outrun Kraven. So let's try to do as much damage as we can before we retreat.
Squad 2 regenerating.
Yes, Deacon.
Oh, we have a
command vehicle is in our line of fire. Squad 2 taking hostile fire.
Received.
shall move at once, Deacon.
All right.
Move command.
Form up. We'll attack them.
Squad 2 regenerated. Squad 2 lost one. Fuck. Squad 2 taking hostile fire.
All right, we're taking some losses. Crusaders start.
Squad 2 regenerated.
Once we get these Crusaders in here, they should be able to mess up the Terradynes from behind.
Squad 2 taking hostile fire. Hostile Terradyne eliminated.
All right, everyone engage. There we go. Squad 1, move up and provide support.
Squad 2 taking hostile fire.
All right, we just gotta keep the command vehicle alive.
Squad 2 regenerating.
Order received.
Hostile Terradyne eliminated. Squad 2 taking hostile fire.
All right.
Hostile Terradyne eliminated.
Looks like they have two more light Terradynes.
Squad 2 taking hostile fire.
We can engaging enemy. Take those with ease, I think.
We are on our way.
We'll move our Crusaders around to flank.
We will move.
Move order received.
All right, let's move up here, draw their attention, flank with the Crusaders, hit them from behind again.
Squad 2 taking hostile fire. Hostile Terradyne eliminated.
Okay, I didn't want you to move that far up.
Yes,
all right, looks like we got him on the run. There we go. Just target the far ones, and they'll destroy everything else on the way. So let's destroy the rest of this base. We should have, hopefully, some pretty veteran units after this mission, then. I mean, they should already be veterans, being the survivors of the attack on the Order command base, but... There we go. Everyone pick your targets. I do want to give a few extra kills to the Light Terradyne since they had some losses, so I want to give them some experience to make up for it. And honestly, if things keep going this well, we might be able to clear up all the... all the other outposts too. I don't think that'll do anything other than grant a little extra veterancy to our units for all the extra destruction they cause, but still, it's a lot more than Sarah was able to do on her first mission, since hers was basically get in, get out. Granted, this mission was the same, but we had more powerful equipment. She only had one squad of Marines, whereas we have a squad of Marines and the Light Everdines. And to be fair, we did win against superior forces. They had a couple Marines at the outpost, undoubtedly, and 8 light Terradynes against our 4. So destroying twice our number with 50% casualties arguably isn't the worst results. But they could be better, too.
Attack order received.
They can have it. All right, you guys destroy all these containers. I have no idea if these containers count as like full buildings or not, but at the very least, they should be getting the equivalent to some of those destruction medals that Kraven like to hand out. There we go.
Attack order received. Yes, Deacon. Yes, Deacon.
All right, we'll move these guys a little closer since their accuracy is lacking. That what basically look like standard shipping containers are standing up the plasma weaponry as long as they are is amusing to say the least. All right. And there's a few more containers down. There we go. Now they can focus on that assembly plant. You guys reform up here. You didn't quite form up how I wanted you to. And it looks like they should be the last of their base. That I don't see any more pockets. The rest seem like roads. Well, not really roads, but passages leading out. I take that back. There is this pocket here that will have the Crusaders. I keep wanting to call them Marines, but no, they're Crusaders. Well, the Crusaders investigate that. Well, they even do, like, they have the Kraven emblem on this processing plant. So it's kind of cool that the factions use visibly different buildings. I always appreciate that. Alright, they should have this assembly plant down. We'll let, is it Deacon Thomas, my brain wants to say? I didn't pay enough attention during the briefing, apparently.
Squad 2 regenerating.
But, he should be able to... We'll let him finish off that building, let him get some veterancy. Alright, we got some equipment storage here and a weapon factory.
Yes, Deacon, we are moving. Move order received.
Alright, so let's set up there.
Enemy structure destroyed.
Alright, we'll have the Marines come in and take the weapon factory while these guys hit the equipment storage. The Deacon should be finishing up with the assembly plant then. Alright, and these storage buildings look like they're going to fall pretty quickly. Alright, and that should be the last pocket of this base. So with that, I'm feeling like some extra credit. So I think we're going to go around and we're going to finish off that little box at that depot. But then I want to go around and hit all the other depots and then we can go to the pickup.
Enemy structure destroyed.
All right, they can focus on the next one.
We're moving, Deacon. Move order.
Let's move up a little more. There we go. Oh, it's even got a door peep that our way oversized infantry here could move through. I won't give them too much shit about scaling being what it is, for the buildings at least. Obviously they should probably be bigger, but you know, constraints of the day and all that. And at least the units are relatively proportional to each other. Alright, Command APC is gonna move up and pick up the infantry, and then we're gonna go shopping around. Alright, you can add your firepower, I guess. Alright, infantry in. I like how we're basically just one of those 10-ton transporters, but with like a plasma gun attached on the top. Alright, you guys protect the APC. APC is going to move north.
Waypoint added. Waypoint added.
Wherever the base was up. Waypoint I think added. Probably up there makes sense. Yeah.
Command APC taking hostile fire.
Oh, what's going on?
Yes, we shall move it. Move command.
Oh, fuck.
Understood. Yes, we shall move it. Move command.
Understood.
Command vehicle is in line of fire.
It's not feeling so good now.
Squad 2 taking hostile fire.
Alright, move up. We gotta provide support to those Crusaders. Our healing is what's gonna make the difference in this battle. Alright, we're gonna get out of here after this if they're gonna keep sending in reinforcements like this. Alright, squad 2 move in front of the command APC. There we go. Alright, Marines, or
Squad 2,
Crusaders move up.
Squad 2 taking hostile fire.
We're going to try to flank them. There we go. Getting hits on their side armor here.
Squad 2 regenerating.
Squad 2 taking. Let's get our APC up so they can add their firepower. Keep advancing.
We're moving, Deacon.
Squad 2 regenerating.
Alright, Command APC is taking a lot of damage here. But otherwise, things are looking good. There we go. Spread out so we can all fire at once. Alright. I don't know how many other forces here, so we're gonna get out. I still think we did pretty good. We lost 3 light Hoverdynes for... what now? 16 light Pterodynes, I think? Which is a
squad one regenerate.
Pretty good trade, all things considered. But we, if they send like another group of 8 light Pterodynes, we might not be able to stand up to that, so... as much as I wanted to go around and have some fun, I think we're going... what?
Just
do what you need to do to get up there. Alright, looks like they're going this way instead. And certainly if I had, like, even just a deployable repair station, I could repair my APC, I might be more willing to, I might be more willing to stick it out, but...
yes, Deacon.
Okay.
We shall move at once, Deacon.
You follow them. Because with how weak my APC is right now, I don't want them running headfirst into another group of Pterodynes here, so... I thought after that first group we'd be in the clear, but I guess not. Although, we are, we can go and finish this guy off, I guess.
Yes, Deacon, we are moving.
I might be getting a little greedy here, but we're right here, so why not, you know? Of course, here I find another 2 squads and die. It would be just my luck. But.
Target added. Yes, Deacon.
And it's just 1 container.
Yes,
but
Deacon, we are moving.
Gotta fill our orders. Okay, there's a few more containers. I'm a little disappointed they didn't leave the other outposts on our screen as secondary objectives, but... well, at least according to the announcer, the containers count as structures. Man, you could level up, theoretically, level up like bombers so fast by just bombing a huge container yard. Alright. And head up there for pickup. And the APC shall follow. Oh, I wanted to zoom in more. What? Why is my zoom in? Whatever. Don't care. I do care, but my zoom is inverted all of a sudden, which is annoying. Yeah. Huh. Oh, well. Not the worst thing I've ever had to deal with in an RTS, so I think I'll live. Alright, hopefully no one else is waiting for us up here. I see our APC is choosing the worst possible route.
Mission
accomplished. There we go. And here comes the dropship.
I begin this confession with the hope that it will someday find its way into the hands of a priest, so that my thoughts and actions may be judged, and if I still live, the necessary corrections be made in my faith. I freely admit to the sin of pride in pursuing this campaign without the guidance of the clergy, but we have had little choice. The Order is surely sending reinforcements, and these heretics must be delayed until they arrive. Paladin Magnus and I must coordinate our efforts and strike where the enemy least suspects us. Sometimes the will of God is left to simple soldiers to carry out. I can only hope the priests will agree with my interpretation.
Alright, so it looks like we're starting on the easternmost continents. We must have fled there via dropship after the fall of the Order base in the polar regions. I forget what that continent was called. I think this one was the Focult Rift. That one was a desert of some sort. I completely forget what it was. The Badlands, maybe? But as far as our mission performance goes, Jared Stone, okay, so his name isn't Thomas at all. He is still unproven. He has one mission with two confirmed kills and one building destroyed, so I guess he didn't really do all that much. Fair enough. I like how they have different ranks here, too. The Dark Prophets have achieved the rank of Faithful. In their active mission, they have 9 confirmed kills and 46 buildings destroyed. Okay, so they are using the same medals. It's a little unfortunate, but we have a medal for Field Excellence and Destruction. And we have the Soul Reaper, who I think were just one medal short of the Destruction medal, who are still unproven, probably because they 3/4 of their experience technically died with the unit. But they suffered 3 lost vehicles on this mission, but they had 11 confirmed kills and 24 buildings destroyed and were granted a medal for aggression. And in fact, their kills... where is it? Is it just... Here, mission stats. We can see we killed 2 Kraven Marines, 16 Kraven Light Pterodynes, 4 support Pterodynes technically, because the 10-ton transporters, I believe, count as APCs. And 71 enemy buildings, all for the cost of 3 light hoverdynes. So, a very excellent lightning raid that ended up being not so lightning and less of a raid. But, it's a start. It's a start. I'm excited to see where this campaign goes. So, with that, thank you all for watching and stay tuned for next time. And stay safe out there, and we'll see you then.